Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Tom Bloxham, and I'm very proud to be Chancellor of this great university. Being Chancellor is not my day job, it's a purely ceremonial, and despite the title and being the titular head of the university, I'm actually not a very important person in the university. The Vice-Chancellor is clearly much more important. My day job is I run a property company called Urban Splash. But one of the great privileges of being Chancellor, in fact, one of the few but very important privileges, is I can pick whichever graduation ceremony I want to, and I particularly wanted to be here with you this afternoon. I was lucky enough to take over from the previous Chancellors, which were Terry Leahy, who ran Tesco's from UMIST, and Anna Ford from the BBC, who was Chancellor of the Victoria University of Manchester, after the merger a number of years ago between UMIST and Victoria University. And I always remember when I got elected, Anna Ford was very kind to me and phoned me up and said, "Congratulations, Tom. If you ever want any advice or anything I can do, please ask me." And I thought for a second or two and I said, "Actually, there is one question I could ask you. What exactly does a Chancellor do?" And she said, "Well, that's a very good question." She wasn't quite sure, but the best explanation she had heard was Bill Bryson, who, when he became Chancellor of Durham, said he thought chancellors would be like B-days. Everyone wanted one, but no one quite knew what they were for. But it's my honour and privilege to welcome you here to the University of Manchester and the splendid surroundings we're in of Whitworth Hall. It's quite apt, I think, we're here today. The Whitworth Hall was named after Sir Joseph Whitworth. He was a very clever individual, a philanthropist, generous, and an inventor. And we still got the Whitworth screws named after him. And this building was designed by Paul Waterhouse. Again, very talented. He was the son and partner of Alfred Waterhouse, who also designed Manchester Town Hall and the Natural History Museum. And his uncle was Edwin Waterhouse, who gave his name to Price Waterhouse Coopers, the accountants. So a very talented family, so you're following after some impressive individuals. In particular, I would like to welcome our graduates whose magnificent achievements and hard work we're here today to celebrate. And we're also very, very pleased to welcome so many friends and families here. We want to thank you for your support and encouragement that you've given to our graduates during their studies, which has been so important to their success. Just like their tutors, members of staff in their schools and faculties, you too, I'm sure, can be extremely proud of what they have achieved. And perhaps it'd be nice for the graduates just to stand up, turn to their families and friends here, and give them a round of applause for thanking them. Would you just do that for me? Stand up and turn around. Thank you. Thank you. And like many of you, although some 30 years ago, I also decided to come to Manchester University, and it's a big decision which university you come to. And certainly for me, it was a very good decision, and I hope that you feel the same way about it as you graduate. And during the course of your studies, you will have gained the skills and knowledge to help you find success in future years. And although I'm sure you'll be pleased to see the end of assignments for now, the planning, research, and writing skills you've deployed and nurtured to date will be a great value in the world of work, or indeed during any further study. The way you have learned to balance commitment to academic life with other interests and the many competing distractions that this great city of Manchester offers will hopefully help you find a work-life balance as your career and future unfolds. And of course, you must not forget the strong supportive friendships and relationships you have forged here, which I hope you'll work on sustaining for many years. Hopefully many people in this room will be your friends for years to come. But put simply, your achievement in completing your degree is truly significant, not only for what it says about your own commitment and accomplishments, but for its value and strong platform it gives you to build your career and achieve your goals. Manchester is already one of the finest universities in Europe, but we are determined to become one of the best in the world. Our ambitious plans lift Manchester into the very first rank of virtuosity in higher learning. But it isn't just the bricks, mortar, wires, technology, equipment, and pieces of paper that make this university so great and successful. It's our students and our staff. During your studies, you will have all in your own way enriched and helped to mould this University of Manchester to the tremendous benefit of those who will follow in your footsteps. Armed with your academic success, your skills, your breadth of experience, there is every reason to be positive about the future, Your job prospects are enviable because employers all around the world recognise the value of the piece of paper you'll soon be holding in your hand. The degree you earn today is very important, but not might be the most important thing you take away from the university. I hope you've also learned lots of other life skills. I came here to study 30 years ago politics and modern history, and in many ways that wasn't particularly useful for the career I chose, and I went on to set up in businesses, selling records and posters, run bars and nightclubs, run a radio station, and then go on to run a property company called Urban Splash and be a trustee of the Tate and Manchester International Festival. And in some ways the politics taught me not much, and a joke saying the most important thing I learned politically was whoever you vote for, the government always seems to get in. But my experience of life says it's not just your degree, and I got a fairly average 2-2, but the other things you learn at university. And for me, the things I really took away was having the confidence to start up my own business, learning to get on with a very diverse group of people that I was thrown together with, the ability to analyze information, the ability and actually encouragement to question convention, to challenge conformity, to think imaginatively, to argue passionately. And my advice to you, for what it's worth, and free advice is usually worth exactly what you pay for it, but my advice to you is to go out from here and to be confident. I always think there are two types of people in this world, those who think they can and those who think they can't, and both sets of people are exactly right. To have a vision, to start with the end in mind, because if you don't know where your destination is, you're unlikely to ever get there. To search out and find what you really enjoy, because my experience of life says if you find something you love doing, you'll be good at it. To be happy and prepared to make mistakes and to learn from those mistakes. To be lucky and to take chances. And perhaps most of all, to persevere. Once you've found what you want to do, be ambitious and go for it. And I think now is a great time to start, to be leaving university, to start in the work, to start out in business. Obtaining your degree is a hugely important milestone and you should relish your success. But I very much hope that this is not the end of your journey with the university, but the beginning. The return on your investment continues way beyond today's celebrations. Our careers service continues to offer help and support for those years, and we can continue to make good use of our world-class libraries. And I'd urge you to contact the Alumni Association, which I never did actually when I left, and I regret not contacting now. The Alumni Association will put you in contact with over 250,000 people who's also graduates of Manchester, who may be working in similar fields to you and all around the world. Interestingly, I went to Hong Kong and met the graduates of Manchester University there. In a small room, 20 or so people, there were a number of MPs, a number of the real leaders of the business. It's a badge of honour that you can keep wearing as long as you continue to work and live around the world. So we sincerely hope today will not be your last contact with the university. And remember that our door is always open to you. But I'd also ask you to remember that education is a privilege and responsibility. And I would urge you to use your God-given talent and skills you've learned here to make the world a slightly better place. And I hope, like the citizens of ancient Athens, we can all swear an oath that the citizens of ancient Athens had to swear before they became a citizen. And the oath was to leave the city not lesser, but better, greater than we found it. Now I would like to invite Jeremy Gregory to say a little more about your school. Thank you very much.
Chancellor, colleagues, graduands and your families and friends, as head of the School of Arts, Languages and Cultures, I'm delighted to congratulate those of you graduating today on your stunning success in obtaining your degrees. Colleagues in the school are extremely proud of what you have achieved. They have worked closely with you for 3 years or more if you have been awarded a PhD. Some of you graduating today have studied with us for your BA, MA and PhD programs, meaning that you've showed loyalty to us for over 7 years and that you've become very much part of our academic community. Many of you who are being awarded a PhD today have also been graduate teaching assistants, working alongside us in teaching our undergraduates, so that you are our valued colleagues as well as our inspiring students. We hope that whether you're being awarded a BA, an MA, or a PhD today, you found your time here intellectually and academically stimulating. Because whatever else studying for a degree gives you. The experience should have been one where you found yourself both challenged and excited, and where you yourselves have become authorities on the topics you've researched. I'm extremely grateful to my colleagues for having given you that experience. For many of you, I have no doubt it will have transformed your lives, though you may not know it yet. I'd therefore ask you all to join me in thanking the teaching and support staff and your supervisors for all their efforts and dedication during your time with us. This ceremony in our magnificent Whitworth Hall reminds us of the bold Victorian hopes and aspirations for our university. It also reminds us that the disciplines you've studied here have had a long and distinguished record, and this university was a pioneer in several of these. When the university was founded in 1851, classics, history, and English were the main art subjects offered. English was part of the syllabus here long before at Oxford or Cambridge. The Faculty of Theology was opened in 1904, with Manchester being the first English university to offer courses in comparative religion. And colleagues in religions and theology have had a long tradition of validating degrees offered by partner colleges, and it's good to see students from Luther King House here today. Manchester was the first university in the world to offer American studies in 1947. And art history formally became a department in the 1950s, with the first endowed chair in the discipline in the UK. The archaeology department was formed in the 1960s, and our Centre for New Writing came into being in 2007, with the Humanitarian and Conflict Response Institute first offering programmes in 2009. And one of the opportunities offered by the school is the possibility for students to take courses from across the 17 different disciplines in the school and in other parts of the university. And it's good to see undergraduate students graduating from the Centre for Combined Studies today. I'm very pleased to say that all these departments and programmes are flourishing and are known for their excellent teaching, research, and engagement with the wider public. In terms of research, a number of our departments are ranked in the top 5 in the country. Colleagues have had success in receiving external funding for their research, and a number of those have included PhD studentships, which have helped fund your research. And over the last 2 years, the university has made some 20 new lecturer and professorial appointments in these areas, indicating its continued investments in these subjects. One of the great advantages of the school are its obvious rich cultural assets, notably the John Rylands Library Deansgate, the Whitworth Art Gallery, and the Manchester Museum. These are undoubtedly amongst the most important research, as well as teaching resources, enjoyed by any university in the UK. And I know that many of you will have used them in your studies, especially in your dissertations. And the university plans to use these resources even more at postgraduate level. Already, some MA teaching takes place in these institutions, and we're looking forward to raise funds to have targeted PhD studentships to work on the Rylands' unrivaled collections. Today, the school has one of the largest concentration of PhD students and MA students in arts and languages in the UK, with over 300 MA students and over 400 PhD students. Our current programmes are designed to prepare our students both for professional life outside the academy, as well as those who might want to pursue an academic career. We have, for example, pioneered doctoral programmes in professional practice, notably in museum studies and arts management and in humanitarianism and conflict and peace studies. We have a director of research training in the arts who has had a brief not only to encourage students in research methods, but also in the skills needed for the world of work. And last September, we launched a graduate school offering both a physical and web-based presence to help foster a sense of academic community amongst our graduates and to enable them to make the most of the inter- and multidisciplinary opportunities on offer within the school. When Manchester, along with other English universities, started to offer postgraduate programmes in 1918, it was soon realised that without adequate funding and proper facilities, it would be difficult to attract large numbers of students. And these issues have remained serious concerns for the last 100 years. The university is committed to improving its facilities for its postgraduates, and where possible, to seek funding for their support. I'm pleased to report that the Arts and Humanities Research Council have approved funding for the North West Doctoral Training College with 200 studentships over the next 5 years, and with this university as the lead institution. We're also one of the partners in the AHRC Centre for East European Language-Based Area Studies. And taken together, these awards strengthen the case that the school is one of the leading providers of postgraduate study in arts and languages in the UK. In all this, it's clear that funding for MAs will be a major issue in the future. And I'm pleased to report that any student obtaining a first-class BA from the university will be awarded £1,000 bursary to pursue postgraduate work here. After this ceremony, I invite you to join colleagues for a reception. Graduates from archaeology, religions and theology, and classics and ancient history should go to the atrium in the graduate school in the Ellen Wilkinson building. Graduates from history should go to the north foyer of the Samuel Alexander building, and all other graduates in the school should go to the Contact Theatre. I hope you enjoy today. Please keep in touch with us and visit us when you're back in Manchester. We wish you the very best of luck for the future and look forward to hearing how you're doing. Thank you very much.
Chancellor, on behalf of the Senate of the University, I present to you for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Christopher Andrew Ord. Veronica Barnsley. Stuart Cunningham. Simon Denham. Luke Kelly. Philip Leake. Mila Milani. Jonathan Morris. Lucy O'Connor. Michael Peter Perduniak. Siavash Rafi Rad. Julia Linda Snape. Karina Senta Spalding. Stevie Spiegel. Panagiota Naya Centuru. Veronica Turiano. Matthew James Whittle. David Wilkinson. Veronica And for the degree of Master of Enterprise in Arts and Cultural Management, Faye Louise Miller. And for the degree of Master of Arts in American Studies History, Catherine Parkin. And in American Studies, Literature and Culture, Jessica Lynn Wilson. And in Archaeology, Daniel Calderbank. Emily Hayter. Lene Cecilia Lundemo. And in Art Gallery and Museum Studies, Nicholas Frederick Baker. Emily Chandler. Elizabeth Amy Griechen. Catherine Jane Haldenby. Susanna Claire Warren Hill. Rebecca Horn. Hannah Elizabeth Howell Jones. Christopher John Keady. Eva Kovatsova. Phoebe Letitia Michael John McLaughlin. Chloe Ellen Morley. Elizabeth Price. Shelley Denise Smith. Michaela Federica Thompson. Dai Young. And in art history, Jessica Elizabeth Lucinda Barnett. Gemma Catherine Meek. Martha Clementine Plutt. And in Arts Management, Policy and Practice, Tariq Bajwa. Oliver Benjamin Bliss. Victoria Jane Brown. Vittoria Caradonna. Stefan Jamie Evans. Anne-Marie Farrell. Regina Saskia Herholz. Nicola Elizabeth Schack. Sofia Beatriz Lobos Araya. Shanchen Lu. Michael O'Connor. Lorna Tam. Pang Zhang. And in Classics and Ancient History, Abigail Laura Ambage. Helen Elizabeth Dalton. Bethan Rose John. Leo James Elliott Mitchell. Christopher James Mowat. William Mundy. Anna Kate Stevenson. And in contemporary literature and culture, Suzanne Louise Borichter. Julie Downing. Amy Catherine Kilvington. David James Martin. Nicole Peters. Kyle John Rice. And in creative writing, Alexander James Allison. David Barker. Blas Barragan Jr. Polly Olive Checkland Harding. Caroline Victoria Chisholm. Callum Harry Coles Jambers. Lucinda Gillian Croft. Sophie Ellis. Erin Fitzgerald. Rory Michael Gleason. Helen Mifanvi Isaris. Grace Francis Laszlo. Usma Malik. Daniel McVeigh. Uchechukwu Ann Okonkwo. Jocelyn Christopher Stephen Richards. Alicia Jean Ruverall. Holly Faye Thompson. Melissa Irene Velliver. And in early modern history, Hannah Katrina Robb. Michael Andrew Lloyd Smith. And in economic and social history, Paul Martin Johnson. And in English and American Studies, Maliha Mohammed Al-Mulhim. Luke Jack Gordon Carson. Marijin Martha Francisca Henrika Nicola Selin. And in gender, sexuality, and culture, Sophie Lee Brown. And in history, Wesley Davidson. Misha Ewan. Barry Edward Johnson. Sarah Frances Setter. Rosanna Webster. Sophia White. Daniel Willis. And in humanitarianism and conflict response, Holly Budget. Dean John Butcher. Nancy Jean Dent. Rachel Elizabeth Duckett. Nicole Dullier. Emily Ann Heiser. Jessica Jill Wingate Hopf. Noah Kimmett. Katie Emma Lee. Melody Davina Nairn. Samuel Patrick Roger. Ashley Graham William Smart. And in international disaster management, Martina Benassi. David Gareth Lees. And in Jewish studies, Alice Atzhead. And in literature and culture, 1200 to 1700, Wendy Woodhead. And in medieval studies, Holly Dusnip. Rebecca Lewis Griffiths. Esther Hyde. And in modern British history, Alice Elizabeth Coker. Bethan Rebecca Folks. Robert Alexander Mingham Smith. James Southern. And in modern European history, Jenny Louise Ashby. Ross Bosworth Davis. Russell Kenneth Hamilton Norton. Victoria Ann Thompson. And in peace building, James Fagan. Nikita Sanaula. And in post 1900 literatures, theories, and cultures, Oliver George Downing. And in post-colonial literatures and cultures, Ruby Madison Kent. And in religion and political life, Hassan Hafid. James Jackson. And in religion and theology, Hannah Burton. Chi-Yen Moon. And in South Asian studies, Natasha Butt. Rosemary Edgley. And in war, culture, and history, Christina Elizabeth Dean. And in world history, Thomas Anthony Clark. And in religion and political life, Fasilat Nain. And for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Ancient History and Archaeology with Honours, James Ward. And in Archaeology with Honours, Carla Kleins. And in Classical Studies with Honours, Thomas Sumner. And in Comparative Religion and Social Anthropology with Honours, Christian Cosgriff. And in English Language with Honours, Lauren Jade Boydell. And in English Literature with Honours, Ellen Bowes. Laura Fletcher. Rebecca Tuesday Murrell. Francesca Toby. And in European Studies in Modern Languages, French, with Honours, Jonathan Rowe. And in History, with Honours, Paul Hewson. John Lee Howe. Kirsty Louise Humphreys. Claire Maria McQuire. And in History and Sociology with Honours, Benjamin Harrison. And in History of Art with Honours, Lorraine Devlin. Rochelle Lisa Lin. And in History of Art and Spanish with Honors, Natalia Boñeca. And in Linguistics with Honors, Lauren Baxendale. Zoe Catherine Isherwood. And in Linguistics and Sociology with Honors, Ellis English. And in Modern Middle Eastern History with Honors, Jesse Jean Zena. And in Philosophy and Hebrew with Honors, Adam Shimon Rosano. And in Religions and Theology with Honors, Jonathan Sparks. And in Russian Studies with Honors, Maria Katerina Kalokoti. And in Study of Religions and Theology, Religion and Society with Honors, Merim Lila Mann. And for the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Historical Studies in Classical Civilization with Honors, Sophie Alice Avalon Slater. And in Film Studies and Historical Studies with Honors, Joshua Harper. And for the degree of Master of Arts in Contextual Theology, Dominique Darcy. Chris Dunbar. Pauline Jane Ingle. Janet Mary Kemp. Richard Halford Pickering. And for the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Contextual Theology with Honors, Fiona Jane Elvins. Jan Fraser. Carol Nutton.
On behalf of the University of Manchester, I once again would like to congratulate all of you who are graduating here today on your excellent and outstanding achievements. I wish you every success and happiness in your future lives and careers. I now declare this ceremony closed. Please stand.